Betaine and pepsin. Let's talk about everything you need to know about these two together and things that you want to avoid. Betaine has become a popular supplement these days for helping reverse low stomach acid. It's a combination of choline and glycine, which helps to break down proteins, specifically homocysteine, and it's derived from food sources like grains and beets. It's also important for proper liver function and making carnitine. Pepsin is just as important because it depends on that acidic environment in your stomach so you can properly digest your proteins. When there's a lack of pepsin and an imbalance of stomach acid, several issues can develop, including bloating, constipation, diarrhea, indigestion, and sometimes even acid reflux. But specifically, something I want to point out, SIBO, or small intestinal bacterial overgrowth. So let's get started. Also, real quick before we get started, it would mean the world to me if you hit the like button down below for the YouTube algorithm and turn the bell on to stay up to date with new weekly videos. Let's talk about what betaine is in more depth. The more we know, the better we can understand its role. You can also find a link to my Thorne store down below where you will find betaine HCL with pepsin, as well as shop my entire supplement collection, as well as my top three favorite supplements. So just like some of your B vitamins like folate and B12, betaine is considered to be a methyl donor in the same way, which is just fancy for supporting your liver function as well as your cellular function, but most importantly, how it helps the body process fats. In fact, the most studied use for betaine actually comes from meta-analysis on its use in supporting the conversion of homocysteine to methionine, which is great because we don't want our homocysteine levels to be too high, because high levels of homocysteine can be harmful to blood vessels, which may lead to plaque buildup and atherosclerosis, which is a condition betaine is said to help with. But betaine HCL, specifically the HCL version, is an acidic version of betaine that works in the same way as hydrochloric acid in your stomach. Your stomach needs adequate levels of stomach acid to break down food. It just does. And pepsin is also required to help digest and absorb nutrients, especially if your body has a hard time digesting proteins. In fact, we have a fascinating pilot study that looked at this in more depth on how betaine HCL safely reduced your gastric pH levels in those who have had hypochlorhydria, which is a lack of acid in the gastric fluid, which can sometimes happen from H. pylori or from using heartburn medicines for too long. These things can increase your stomach pH, making it more alkaline and less acidic. And remember, you need your stomach acid to be at the right pH level for optimal function. Oftentimes, stomach acid gets hate because of heartburn and reflux issues, which can be very frustrating. But remember, you need these acids so you could properly break down the food and prime the food for digestion. A stomach pH of 1 to 2 is ideal for this to happen. Notice how the pHs differ depending on where you are in your digestion. These all need to be at the right amounts to not only allow the good bacteria to remain at the amounts they need to be, but also destroy the bad bacteria that can overgrow. And I'll leave a link to these studies down below for you to look at. So that sums up betaine HCL. Let's talk about pepsin now in more depth. You see, your gastric cells secrete pepsin in its initial form called pepsinogen, which is needed to break down proteins into smaller peptides and amino acids that can be easily absorbed in the small intestine for later. And cells within the stomach lining called parietal cells secrete hydrochloric acid that helps lower the stomach's pH, making it easier for the pepsin to do its job. It's a fine balance between the two. And while there are many different reasons why people take betaine HCL and pepsin together, which I can discuss in more videos, I wanted to dive into this one interesting thing: low stomach acid and SIBO. You see, food that is undigested in your GI tract can be very uncomfortable. For example, it can start to ferment, which can lead to gut bacteria overgrowth in your small intestine. Low stomach acid also leaves you vulnerable to H. pylori, which is tied back to gastritis and peptic ulcer disease. This is probably one of the most important functions of your stomach acid. Besides breaking down food, you need it to destroy the bacteria before it enters the small intestine. And currently, this only affects about 2% of the population in the US. Doesn't seem like much, but testing for hypochlorhydria is not common actually, so I would imagine the numbers being a lot higher. And you might be thinking, well, who is more prone to this? Who is more susceptible and could possibly benefit from betaine? Well, there are a few conditions that make you more likely to develop it, two of which we've already discussed, being One on long-term heartburn medicines and H. pylori. Then there are certain autoimmune conditions, being over 65 years of age and having anemia or pernicious anemia. And it's hard to really identify symptoms because the symptoms of having low acid really mimic signs of too much stomach acid. And that's why this is so tricky. So my best recommendation is to definitely bring this up to your primary care doctor if you fall into this category, or you have symptoms like burping, bloating, feeling really full after eating, reflux, heartburn, or indigestion that is too bothersome. In terms of supplementing with betaine HCL, there's no established daily value that you need to absolutely take, but being conservative about dosing is ideal. The Thorne supplement uses 1 gram of betaine and 47 milligrams of pepsin. In my opinion, these are ideal amounts, and a trial period of 1 to 2 weeks will help you determine it's going to be helpful in the long run. It's fast acting and the effects are short term, which means it's best to take it with your meals. If you notice improvements in your symptoms, that's a good thing. You can continue to take it, but if there's no improvement in your symptoms after 2 weeks, then you could stop taking it. And there are about 3 safety tips that I want to leave you with if you decide to go with it. The first is that betaine is contraindicated in peptic ulcer disease, so definitely do not take it if that is you or if you have peptic ulcers. Secondly, do not take it with your H2 blocking antacids and proton pump inhibitors. They will counteract each other. And thirdly, there is this idea that you can increase your dose until you feel that burning sensation, right? And then decrease your dose slightly. So if your stomach burns after 8 of them, then your ideal dose is 7. Don't use this method, as you can damage your stomach lining by taking this much. And if you want to find natural sources of betaine as well, one of the best places you can find it is in beets. 1 cup of raw beets will give you about 175 milligrams of betaine. But I'm more curious to hear from you guys though. What are your thoughts on betaine? Leave them in the comments below. And until then, guys, I'll see you on the next one.